Hi, and welcome to this quick tutorial on Windows cluster scanning. We start on our normal Windows Server page. So this is a normal Windows asset. You can see the usual information that Lansweeper retrieves. At the top, there's a dedicated tab for Windows clusters where you can get more detailed information. This will basically just give you basic information about the cluster, the name, the FQDN, IP address, and then most importantly, we have the different nodes within our cluster. This cluster only has two nodes, so we have the server that we're on right now, and then we have the secondary server. These are hyperlinked, so if you want to take a look at the other nodes, you can easily do so. And then another big addition to this is the Windows cluster logs. So if you have Windows clusters set up, we'll also scan the specific Windows cluster log files to really give you additional depth of information of what is happening on those clusters, the things that have changed over time. Basically, anything that is recorded within the log file is also pulled into Lansweeper. So regardless what type of cluster you have, whether it be a database cluster, a file storage cluster, whatever it might be, we'll be able to scan which nodes are in the cluster. You'll see the Windows cluster logs, so you can get all of that detailed information now. So if we head back to our summary, at the bottom, as you might have seen, there are some Hyper-V guests. Just like any other Windows cluster, we also scan Hyper-V clusters. But for Hyper-V clusters specifically, we also now list them on the asset page and they're hyperlinked too. So previously, we would have these listed, but we wouldn't create assets of them. Now we also scan the Hyper-V from the host itself and we create a new asset with that specific information. So we'll take a look here at one of the Hyper-V assets. So this is an Hyper-V guest that has only been scanned through the host. So that's why there's a little bit of limited information here. There's not much that you can see from this. If we take a look here at one that we've scanned with Lansweeper directly, then you'll see there's quite a big difference of the amount of information that you can retrieve. On this asset page, you also can see that we have the Hyper-V guest name as well as the Hyper-V host. So you can easily navigate between the host and guest machines. Just like the other cluster scanning, at the top, we have a new tab for the Hyper-V log. We've kind of separated those to make sure that the log files are not cluttered too much. So here you can see all the log files for the Hyper-V cluster specifically. So you can see that the new Hyper-V machines were created and realized and that the service was started, etc. So you can get that extra level of detailed information for your Hyper-V clusters. So similar to all the other new additions and features, we also have some extra reports that we've added for cluster scanning. So if we take a look here at new cluster reports, here at the bottom, we have three new ones. So we have all the clustered nodes, we have cluster logs and cluster node count. Take a look here at all of our cluster logs. Now this will have all the cluster logs within your Lansweeper installation. If you have a lot of clusters in your installation, this will be quite full. So again, you can use the filters at the top to kind of filter out specific events that you want to see. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about Lansweeper, head over to our website, start your free trial, or take a look at these videos.